somebody like Tompolo, who has not been in any government position before, who has not been given any responsibility in terms of manning any government position, you are chasing the man that the man need to come and answer, you know, to some issue of corruption. On what level? Well, sincerely, we know that what they are trying to do is to see how they can eliminate the only voice we have in the Niger Delta region. I am calling on the entire Niger Delta people to rally around Tompolo to ensure that what is due the Niger Delta people will come to us. The reason is simple. If you don't have a voice, if you don't have somebody who will stand and say, yes, this is what we want in the Niger Delta region. Yes, we've seen the papers, we've seen all the documents, we've seen all the agreements, and what we sat down to discuss is not what you are implementing. If you don't have that kind of force, you cannot achieve what is supposed to come to your region. So we've identified, you know, one very vibrant individual who sincerely wants the good of this land. We need to come together as a people and support this person. It is only with this kind of attitude that the government will realize that we know the direction to which we are heading. So they can stop, you know, this madness of trying to destroy those who sincerely want this region to move forward. I don't want a situation whereby we'll start regretting after maybe something disastrous must have happened. Because today, people will tell you that we are celebrating Ken Saro-Wiwa. But when the government came after him, and even before they took his life, how many leaders within the Niger Delta region stood up against that kind of oppression? How many tribes came out to say, yes, this is our brother, you must not touch him? But some of these agitations, we started from even Adakaboro to Ken Saro-Wiwa, and today we have Tompolo, is the reason why some of the small benefits we are enjoying today came. If you look at the issue of even the NDDC that was created, it was as a result of the petition that was written by the Ogoni people, led by Ken Saro-Wiwa, to the African Commission, that the Nigeria country as a member state in the African Union is not, you know, living up to the minimum core obligatory responsibility that was placed on them. And when this petition was written to the African Commission, the Nigeria government, you know, hurriedly set up the Niger Delta Commission just to show to the African Commission that, yes, we are living up to expectation in terms of the minimum core obligation that was placed on us. Today, the benefit that is coming from the Niger Delta, you know, the Niger Delta Development Commission is not only going to the Ogoni people, but the Ishekiris are benefiting from it. The Ijaws are benefiting from it. The Ikwayans are benefiting from it. The Urobos are benefiting from it. The Isokos are benefiting from it. So the issue of who should be in front should be a secondary issue. If we identify one person who is sincere in terms of agitating for good things to come to our land, what we need to do is to support that person. So I want to say that the issue of trying to go into the creek and see how you can capture Tompolo is not only illegal, but it's unlawful. Because the man has not done anything. If you think he has done something, let us see. Where are the evidence? Present it to Nigerians. Let's see the evidence, you know, of this the corruption allegation you're laying. We don't want a situation whereby we only celebrate, you know, heroes that are no more. We want a situation whereby we will start celebrating our heroes that are alive, because that is the only way we can head to the promised land. So as I'm talking to you right now, as a free-born Ishekiri person, the imaginary borders between us and our Ijaw brothers, we are trying to bring these things to an end and to ensure that we support those who sincerely want the good of our land. The government should stop the divide and rule tactics. The IOCs should stop the divide and rule tactics. Because in no distant time, we are going to come, you know, as a united front and ask for the things that is due us. So some of the tricks that they've been using in time past, very soon will no longer be effective. So I want to advise our Niger Delta people that we should come together, be our brother's keeper, and ensure that we improve on the standard of living of the people of within the Niger Delta region.